In this lecture, we're going to go over how to work with data which has already been formatted as a pivot table. Now, in the most basic example, I have a pivot table here which has already summarized a piece of data and so doesn't have the other columns available. This workbook has the other sheets deleted, so the original source data tab isn't available here. When the data is still in a pivot table format though, what you can always do is just basically scroll down to the grand total, double click on it to get back to your original table, even if that table has been deleted. An important thing to keep in mind if you're ever sending out work and you think you've deleted your source data. Now that's a relatively simple example, but what happens when somebody does a copy-paste special values of your pivot table? Then you can no longer double-click to drill down into the original table anymore. I've prepared a couple of examples like this so that we can work through not just how to load these files, but also how to transform them as well. So I'm going to come over to here and I'm going to come to Data, Get Data, and I have a couple of Excel files. First one here, Power Query Fill. So here's my file. Our data is sitting in sheet one. So we can see here we have department and county groupings. If I scroll down, I can see that this is effectively, this null value is where the total for that department would sit. And if we went all the way down to the bottom of this data set, which won't be shown in this preview here, then that would basically be showing where the grand total is. So let me take this and I'm going to click edit so I can modify this data set in Power Query. Our data is loaded up, and so what do we want to do with this? Well, effectively we want to fill in all of these nulls and then get rid of these nulls here. So to do that, it's quite simple. We can come over to Transform, and this button here is Fill. So you notice here, I've got a department here. If I scroll down, there's the next department. So that's Department of Transportation, and this one is Department of Public Health. If I select that column and click fill down, then you can see all of these blank rows have been filled in with Department of Health. And then if we come down here, Department of Transportation. If I come over to our county column, we have these null values. All I have to do is click on here and deselect null and click OK. And that's pretty much it. Now, just so you can see what this looks like here, this Power Query has created this process step for us, which is filter the rows. If I click on this little cog, I can see that it's added this criteria does not equal to null. So yep, that's all good. Let's click OK. And then if I come over to home, I can load this data into our spreadsheet. There we go. Let's do another example. So I'm going to come back to data, get data from file, from workbook. And my next example here is Power Query Unpivot. So in this example here, we have basically what used to be a pivot table as well. I've got the sum of annual total pay. That's the values populated here. We have years running across the columns from 2011 to 2017. We have a grand total column over here. And someone has decided that they would insert these blank columns in between. Often this is done for formatting purposes, but makes it more difficult to work without data. So let's click edit here. Okay, so our data is loading up. And we can see to start with, all of the columns are just being called column 1, column 2, column 3. And this little ABC 123 basically means all of these are text fields. Now we know that each of the years contains a column of data containing numeric values. So we'll want to do something about that. Now, if we come over to transform, there is a button over here, which is use first row as headers. Now, this first row here, right, well, let me just click that to start with and you see what happens. Okay, it's taking the word year as the column header. And that's not what we want. What we want is 2011 as the column header, 2012 as the column header, etc. So let's undo that. To undo any step inside of Power Query, all you have to do is come over to these applied steps over here and hit the cross button, the little X button on that to remove that step. So I've removed that step. And what I'm going to do first is I'm actually going to delete this first row. So, oops, sorry, I also have to delete this promote header, so let me delete that step as well. Okay, so this first row here, which includes sum of annual total pay and year, and then all these nulls over here, I'm basically going to delete this row. So I'm going to come over, and on the home tab, there's remove rows. So I'm going to remove top rows, and I'm going to remove the first row, so that pops up. Row number of rows to remove is 1. Okay, that row is gone. And now I can come back and do the same step again as use first row as header. Okay, so that's great. So now you can see that we have these years running across the top as our column names. And it's selected the right data type now as well. So it's changed from ABC 123 to 1.2, which basically means it's a numeric value. The next thing we want to do is effectively we want to unpivot this data. Because right now we have years running across the columns. What we really want to be able to work with this data more effectively to get it into a tidy data format is have the years running down. So each year for each department is sitting in a separate row. So to do that, I'm going to come over here and select department. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use this function called unpivot. So if I click on this button here and click the drop down, we've got a few different options. We've got unpivot columns, unpivot other columns, and unpivot only selected columns. So the columns that we want to unpivot are effectively all of these ones from here to the end. Now there's a few of those and there's only one grouping column here. So by selecting this column, this one column, I can click unpivot other columns, and that's going to unpivot all the other columns except for this one that I've selected. So I'm going to do that. Click here. And here we go. It has nicely transposed all of our data for us. Now, this is something that would have been quite complicated to do before and taken quite a bit of time to do. And with just a couple of clicks, you're able to do this with Power Query. Now, there's a couple more steps I need to do. So the grand totals here, I want to get rid of those. So let me do that. Let me come to the bottom of the list, unselect grand total there. Let's take a look at this field. And grand total there as well. So I've deselected the grand total from both of these columns. It's created this step for us, filtered rows. If I click on the cog, you can see the logic that it's created for us. Does not equal to grand total, does not equal to grand total. Now, this is important. I just wanted to show that mainly because if you have a selection of lots of different items, there's two ways that you can do things. You can either select all of the items on the list, or you can deselect certain items and set it to a does not equal. And the difference between that is if you had logic which selected all of the departments instead of deselecting grand total, if you ever had new departments, then your logic wouldn't work anymore because it wouldn't have that additional department selected. Whereas doing it this way, it continues to work quite nicely. Just wanted to point that out. So click OK. Come back to home, load and close this data. And here is our lovely transformed data set.